right, this is the trumpet. We're going to disassemble it. The first piece you would take off about a quarter turn is your mouthpiece. This is your tuning slide. This is the main tuning slide. This tunes your instrument. You need to either be real good tuning it by ear or use a machine. It's imperative that whenever you take slides out that you press all three vowels down so as not to damage the inside tuning of the trumpet. This is your first valve slide. You push this one out with the first valve slide ring whenever you play a D or an F. This is your second valve slide. You don't do anything with this one. And this is your third valve slide. This one you also kick out whenever you play third position, which is using your third valve. I'm taking off the third valve ring right now. This allows you to push it out whenever you play the third valve. And again, this is the third valve slide. Now when taking out the valves, you must be very careful not to misplace them, or it could mean problems for your instrument, because if you put them in the wrong hole, that can mean anywhere from a half an hour to an hour figuring out where they go. So there's your first valve, and your second valve. And then your third valve. That is all the pieces of the trumpet you can take off. But some of the stationary pieces are your bell, which the sound leaves, your lead pipe, which is all the tubing throughout the trumpet, and then you've got the mouthpiece receiver, which the mouthpiece locks into, and then you have the ring finger, well, the pinky ring, where you just set on top, and that's the trumpet without all of its parts. Next, we're going to clean the trumpet. We'll start with the inside. This is just a lead pipe cleaner. You just put it in there, give it a little twirl, clean it out. And you're gonna use the long one, push through, get a bunch of gunk out. Just pull it all the way through. Then you'll do the other parts of the trumpet. All this gunk is from spit if you've eaten when you played your instrument, which is not good to do at all. It's from condensation from the perspiration from your lips, just coming out. It's nothing too nasty, it's just yours if you're the only one playing it. Next, you also want to use this small lead pipe to clean the mouthpiece, because that's going to be the dirtiest part of your trumpet, right there, as well as the inside lead pipe receiver. You can also use the small ones, the small pipe cleaner, for the third valve slide, the second valve slide, and the first valve slide. You can use the long lead pipe cleaner for the tuning slide. Just push it through there. It won't go all the way through, but it'll get a good amount. And if you're ever in need of the serial code number, it's always right on the left side of the trumpet on the second valve casing. Because this is a newer trumpet, it has rotary valve spit release, so you just press the button and it'll release, but some trumpets have a little trigger where you push it up and the spit will go out. Now we're going to clean the trumpet. This is just a normal silver polishing cloth. We'll just go over it, wipe it a little bit, shine it up, make it look real nice. That's that for the main body. You also want to polish the shiny parts on the tuning slide, the valves, all that good stuff. Just make it look real nice and clean. Shiny. You can also clean the mouthpiece. Get it looking real good. You don't want to take your polishing cloth to the inside of the valves, because that will corrode your polishing cloth because of the valve oil. There's not really much you can do to clean those. Just need to make sure you take care of them, and if you ever do have to clean them, just take your glove and wipe the outside of it. Now we're going to start to reassemble. First of all, you have the mouthpiece. We'll put that one back in first. Then we'll put in the first valve. Remember, you must never forget where you put your first valve. And on my trumpet, you have little black tongs that show you where the valve fits in like. Just make sure that's in there real good. Tighten the valve cap. Then do the same for the second and third valve. After you get all the valves in, it's best to go through and put, first of all, your first valve slide, which is right in the back. Remember to press the valves down to make them go in nice and smooth. As you see, I have a problem here. The valve's stuck down. It's because when we cleaned it, all the valve oil wiped off, so it got sticky. This is valve oil right here. Just take a little bit, rub it on there, get it nice and fluid, and put your valve back in. Should move. Tighten the cap, make sure it goes down like that, and it should just work real good. Then you'll want to put the second valve slide in. Remember the valves push down. Push that on there. And then you want to do your third valve slide. Put that on there. But also make sure you don't forget about your third valve slide ring. Push that right in there. Put your screw back in there so that doesn't move, fall off, doesn't run away from you. Tighten that up. Then last but not least is your tuning slide. The longer side goes towards the bottom. Make sure your valves are pressed down. And if it's not wanting to go in too fluidly, you might have to use the slide grease. Tuning slide is one of the slides that you need. Able to move real easy, so you can tune your instrument and make sure you sound just like everybody else. Then you'll put that back in. We'll leave it about there. So might be in tune. Wipe the extra valve grease off. Then you can polish it one more time. Get nice and shiny. Make sure you put all your materials away. And that's your trumpet.